Hi everyone, and welcome to this tutorial bite for Oxygen Not Included, which is a look at all of the types of exosuits. Exosuits of all kinds are extremely useful for many reasons, and there are four different types. The Oxygen Mask, Atmos Suit, Jetpack, and Lead Suit, which is only available in the Spaced Out DLC. Whilst each type has its own purpose, the mechanics for checkpoints and docks are the same, so I'll start with how this works before looking at each type of exosuit in turn. The suit checkpoint acts as a barrier to dupes and will only allow dupes past in the direction of the arrow if they're already wearing a suit matching the dock or can take a fueled suit from a joined dock. Docks must be placed next to a checkpoint, but you can use as many as you like in a row. It's important to be aware that checkpoints only block a specific route. Therefore, if you want to ensure that an area is only accessible with suits, you must use suit checkpoints at all of the entrances. Block off all other possible routes with tiles, or use doors with restricted permissions. Another key point when using multiple checkpoints to the same area is to use the clearance setting found on the checkpoint buildings. By default, this is set to clearance always, which means dupes can always pass back through the checkpoint, but if there are no empty suit docks, then they will leave their suit on the floor. Therefore, I would highly recommend changing this to clearance vacancy only, which means they will have to find a checkpoint with an available dock, ensuring no suits are dropped on the floor. A common idea is not to have suit access to specific areas, but instead to have a safe base area which then has suit access to the rest of the map. This makes controlling oxygen and temperature much simpler within the base and makes exploring much quicker and safer. The suit docks are slightly different for each type of suit, but each requires an oxygen input through gas pipes. Note that if any other gas is supplied, it will damage the dock and will need to be repaired. I would highly recommend using a self-powered oxygen machine, or SPOM, as these output large amounts of pure oxygen. And for more detail on these, check out my tutorial bite on oxygen, linked in the card. It's generally advisable to supply the oxygen starting from the checkpoint side, as these suits are used most often. I would also advise splitting the pipes instead of running the pipes directly through the inputs, as it may improve suit uptime. Importantly, as dupes consume 100 grams per second of oxygen, and the gas pipe capacity is 1 kilogram per second, the maximum number of docks that can be supplied from one pipe is 10. In practice though, I would limit this to fewer, and 7 or 8 are safe numbers, especially if being used heavily. So moving on to each type in turn, I'll start with the oxygen masks. These are the simplest type of exosuit, and are made at the crafting station, which can be researched early on. The masks themselves are simply made, requiring 50 kilograms of either copper ore, cobalt ore, or aluminium ore, one of which will be accessible in the starting biome, or iron ore. They store 20 kilograms of oxygen, which will last a dupe a third of a cycle, and protect against the yucky lungs and popped eardrums debuffs. However, beware that dupes still breathe out carbon dioxide when wearing these, so they cannot be used when working in vacuum areas. Overall, these are simple and easy to set up, and can help with early exploration. For some tips on exploration, I have a dedicated tutorial bite. I'll also touch here on suit durability, which applies to all exosuit types. This is a mechanic that was added fairly recently, as of the time of recording, which means suits will lose durability over time when worn. Once fully worn, and then docked, they become unusable and need to be repaired. When this happens, a suit dock will automatically request a new suit, and the worn suit can be repaired at the same type of station at which it was made. For this reason, I leave the worn mask or suit recipe on forever. Oxygen masks only require dupe time to repair, and I'll note the material repair cost for the other types of suits as I cover each one. Atmos suits are the next type, and are an extremely powerful and versatile tool, and a great addition to any base. They are made and repaired in the Exosuit Forge, and require 300 kilograms of refined copper, cobalt, aluminium, or iron, as well as 2 units of reed fibre. To repair a worn Atmos suit costs 1 unit of reed fibre, which makes this a key resource for the mid-game and beyond. Reed fibre has 2 sources, the thimble reed plant and shearing dracos. Wild thimble reed plants are ideal as they require no resources and can be freely harvested every 8 cycles. I would therefore recommend leaving these plants intact as you find them on the map. If domesticated, they produce reed fibre every 2 cycles, but consume large amounts of polluted water at 160 kg per cycle. This would require large natural reserves, captured geysers, or large amounts of industrial machinery output, which needs to be carefully temperature managed. For the other method, here you can see a very basic Draco ranch, which is simply a 24x4 room with a split atmosphere of hydrogen and chlorine. Using atmosuits is required in these areas, and using a liquid lock will make managing the gases much easier. If using these for your first reed fibre, you can use oxygen masks to get started. The hydrogen is for the drekos to grow their coats in, and the chlorine is to grow the balm lilies. And you'll need at least 2 balm lilies, but more can be used. Make sure to set these to non-harvest using the harvest overlay found in the bottom right or on the Y hotkey. On the left is the grooming station to domesticate the drekos, as well as a critter drop-off and a shearing station. You'll need a dupe with a critter ranching skill, and with that you can simply wrangle any wild drekos and put them in here, assuming your map has some. When their coats regrow, the shearing station is used and 2 units of reed fibre are then available. Atmosuits almost fully protect dupes, including from status debuffs and germs, and provide significant insulation against heat, up to 727 degrees Celsius. They store 75 kilograms of oxygen, enough for a dupe to breathe for a cycle and a quarter. The carbon dioxide breathed out is also collected in the suit, and only released when it's taken off, making them ideal for working in vacuum areas. I would highly recommend using atmosuits outside of a core base, and it will help with exploring and strip mining, making them quicker and safer. There is also an odd behaviour for dupes that run out of oxygen reserves whilst in a suit. When this happens, they will keep recovering their breath assuming they can find oxygen, but when doing so, they won't consume any. This means they no longer require any oxygen supply, which makes this very useful in the Spaced Out DLC for rocket trips where the dupes stay inside the rocket. For example, in telescoping or drilling missions. It's unclear if this is intended or a bug. In addition to the oxygen input, the suit docks also require 120 watts of power. However, this is only consumed when recharging. For this reason, it's possible to exceed the potential capacity of the wires, and I typically exceed this by at least double, so over 2 kilowatts of potential load on a normal 1 kilowatt wire. The main downside of atmosuits is the athletics penalty of -6 that dupes get when wearing them. This can be countered with the suit wearing skill, but this was reworked from a tier 2 to a tier 3 skill, and so requires good morale to sustain. Another way to counteract this penalty is to simply have dupes with high athletics. Typically, older dupes will have high levels of athletics simply from completing tasks, and the main issue is with new dupes. For this reason, you may wish to use a duplicate gym to raise their athletics attribute. The gym is a community nickname for a setup similar to the one shown here. There are multiple ways of setting this up, and in this example there's a manual generator connected to a light. Running on these increases the athletics attribute efficiently. The generator is set to high priority, and the door access is manually controlled to ensure only new dupes can enter the room. Lights are needed to draw power, and also give a small productivity bonus. Timer sensors are used to prevent the dupes from running endlessly, and make sure they go to their downtime. Simply stopping them every 30 seconds or so should be often enough to catch this, but you could time this more accurately with a cycle sensor matched to their schedule. Once they have sufficient athletics, which is usually around 10 or so, they can then be sent out to do tasks to support the colony. I must say that I don't personally use the duplicate gyms, but instead accept the slow new dupes and let them speed up on their own. Next, jet suits are very similar to atmo suits, but with the cool added benefit that it allows dupes to fly, meaning they can reach every tile. They are made from 200 kilograms of steel, as well as 25 kilograms of petroleum that must be supplied from a pitcher pump. The suit docks require an additional piped input of petroleum and are 2 tiles wide, as are the checkpoints. Of course, I covered reed fibre earlier, and for details on making steel and petroleum, see the tutorial bite for plastic and steel linked in the card. Beware that they produce carbon dioxide when flying, and having access to all areas can cause significant frame rate drops due to the pathing. This is because of how the pathing works, and as you can see here, the tree becomes very large. So if using these, it may be necessary to limit the available areas to help minimise the pathing, or alternatively, just use atmo suits instead. Finally, lead suits are the last type to cover, and these are unique to the Spaced Out DLC. They are also made in the Exosuit Forge, but from 200 kilograms of lead and 10 kilograms of glass, and are designed to protect dupes from radiation. Wearing a lead suit will reduce the radiation dose absorbed by 2/3, so is useful for dupes working in high radiation areas, for example nuclear reactors. To repair a worn lead suit costs 5 kilograms of glass. In most ways they are like atmosuits and only require oxygen and power. But to highlight the differences, the checkpoints and docks are 2 tiles wide, and the athletics penalty is -8, increased from -6. And that wraps up this tutorial bite about the exosuits in Oxygen Not Included. I hope this was useful, and thanks for watching.